The purpose of this video is to show the user how to set up a custom coordinate system using the map functions in our Civil software. These map functions are identical to the Bentley map functionality in the map software. So why would we need to set up a custom system in the first place? Let's take a look at one example. In this example, we'll be working with the VDOT project coordinate system. As we can see, looking at the PDF, our North American datum 1983 meters have been customized to subtract 1 million meters from the southern zone northing, 2 million meters from the north zone northing, and respectively 2.5 million meters from the easting value. A quick glance at this figure will give us the factor dependent on the county. So our custom coordinate system will have to adjust for the offset or shift between the northern and southern zone, metric values, as we'll be using an English system, and also the scale and elevation factor for the specific counties. To begin, we'll search our computer for our seed.dty file. The DTY will be the file that will hold our custom coordinate system. We'll copy this and we'll create a new folder or location to store our custom coordinates. So I'll drill down into my folder structure and I'll paste this DTY. Next we'll come in and we'll rename the DTY with a logical name. Now we can begin with our software. I'll be working in Power Geopack, and I'll open up a file. At this time, the file needn't have any relevant coordinate information or spatial information attached. The user will first have to go into Workspace Configuration, and we'll need to create a variable. The variable we'll be creating will be ms_geocoordinate_userlibraries. Once created, we'll add the path to our DTY. We'll need to include the actual DTY name. And we'll say OK. And we'll do a file save settings. Save your settings and reopen MicroStation. With our file back open, we'll come in to select the geographic coordinate system. We'll go from a library, and we should see our custom folder. At this time, we have no coordinate systems in place. We can now drill down into our folder structure to extract the appropriate coordinate systems. In this case, I've saved the two systems that we'll be working with in my favorites. So I'll begin with the southern zone. To be able to add to our custom coordinate system, we'll first need to activate map. So I'll use the custom task menu to open Bentley Map. Now I'll select from a library. Again, I'll select my southern zone from my favorites, copy, highlight my custom folder, and paste. Because Virginia is working with two coordinate systems, a northern and southern zone, I'll add both of these. Next, I'll add the northern zone, copy, and paste. With our coordinate systems now copied into our custom folder, we can begin to edit them. So we'll right click on the southern zone and we'll click Edit Coordinate System Properties. I want to change the name and we'll just call this custom underscore template, and we'll leave it set to VA 83 southern feet SF. Next, we will set our projection option and understand that the ellipsoid is the most important part of the definition of the coordinate system datum. So that's kind of why we've opted to copy these systems. What we'll need to do is go in and change our projection to be able to make modifications to it. So we'll use the Lambert conformal conic. However, we'll change it to Lambert conformal conic with a fine processor. This will open up several parameters. Here we can enter our shift values. So with the A0 value, we'll first be entering the shift value for our eastings. Both our northern and southern zone had a common easting of 2.5 million meter shift, so we'll just multiply that by our English conversion unit and we'll come out with the value of 8,202,083.66, I'm sorry, 0.333, and we'll go 9 digits or millionth out. Next, we'll enter our northing, and as we're in the southern zone, the southern zone shift value was 1 million meters, so again, we will enter that in as our factor, multiplied or converted out to English units, and we'll come up with 3,283.33. Let's take that one past yet. Okay. Next, we're going to look at our scale values. These scale values will be entered into our A1 parameter and our B2 parameter. And because these are our templates for all the county systems, we'll just enter those as one. And once they're entered, we'll select OK. We'll repeat the process with our northern zone. Again, we'll say Edit. We'll rename it. And we'll leave the VA 83 northern feet. Again, we'll change our projection to Lambert conformal conic with a fine processor. And we'll enter our A0 value as our easting, which is consistent. are northing. This time will change as we're in the northern zone, so we'll be using 2 million meters, or 6,561,666 feet. And our scale factor, again, we'll set as 1. And we'll say OK. So now we have 2 custom templates added, and we can begin localizing on a county level, which will simply involve adjusting the scale factor. So to begin, I'll be using for this design, the Pennsylvania, and our scale factor is 200 thousandths of a foot. And this is the southern zone. So we'll just copy our template, paste, and we'll edit. And the first thing we'll do is rename it. And we'll say OK. So we'll look these over and actually have to make one minor change here to my templates. Set these to negative values. And this is why we check it. We only have 1 county to update. So we'll reapply our Pennsylvania coordinate system, custom system. Can do a sanity check and export our drawing to Google Earth. And there we have our project. We can turn off our raster reference and use the Google image underneath.